So Amal, you've got a kit here.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a clean, unhacked forearm.
Yeah.
I want one.
All right.
Is it gonna hurt?
A little bit.
So what, you just slash your skin, open it up, and stick in this little
No, slashing or sewing. It's very simple. We just use this injector assembly here. So
hang on a second. That's my hand, bro.
He can open doors, start cars, log into computers, all with a simple wave of his hand. Fans reckon he's unlocked a new kind of evolution, but skeptics say he's dangerous. Amal Grafstra is a biohacker, upgrading the human body with technology to make it do more.
Amal, it's great to meet you. Thanks for being on the show.
Yeah.
Now, when I got to work this morning, I swiped my pass.
Sure.
Like the rest of us.
Yep.
How did you get to work today?
I did the swipe, but nothing in my hand.
How does that work? That sounds creepy, but cool.
Right, I actually have a transponder in my hand that functions much like your badge there.
So you've got multiple RFID implants in your body right now?
Yes. I also have one here and here. So in total, I have 4.
Gentlemen, we can rebuild him. We have the technology.
Amal's implants are about the size of a grain of rice. Little bundles of wiring encased in biocompatible glass sit under his skin that basically make him a little bit robot.
You kind of forget that you have it. It becomes part of who you are in a matter of weeks. I mean, you're sitting there and your kidneys are working hard for you, but you're not thinking about them. It's the same for me. I can just open my doors and log on my computer without thinking.
So basically, you're a hacker.
Yeah, it's applying hacker methodology and ethic to biology. So arriving at solutions through unconventional means.
This guy's really good.
He's not a guy, he's a machine.
What are they gonna do, replace us?
Well, yeah, that's kind of part of Amal's plan.
You know, evolution is selection and mutation. So we have some random mutation, some change, and either that's a good thing and we live, or it's a bad thing and we die. You know, it's selection, right? So we've been opting out of selection for a long time. We're looking at being able to guide where we want to go as a species. It's a new kind of evolution. It's changing things so that we're actually able to make our own decisions about our own lives, but also kind of the future of humanity.
So we're basically going to have a bunch of people looking like the Terminator walking around very soon.
Potentially. I have a fire safe that I open this way. I have a smart gun project where I built. I have a rifle that only fires if I pick it up.
Well, that's worrying.
It's a good thing if you have kids in the house or other kids come over or people want to break in and steal your gun and use it, but they can't.
My mission is to protect you.
Even if you had my username and password, only I can get access to my email because there's an additional challenge, initial crypto thing that needs to be generated here inside my implant.
You've got a website where you basically sell these kits. So anyone can go online, purchase a kit, and put one of these things in their body. That kind of spells illegal to me.
Sure, I mean, it's not any more illegal than selling a knife online or a hobby knife or any kind of thing. You know, people can buy anything and use it for, you know, use it improperly. We want the customer to take this this whole kit to a professional. And that can be your doctor, and some doctors do it.
Resistance is futile.
Okay, so like, let's tell the truth now, honestly. Are you a secret CIA agent?
I'm a secret agent, yeah. No, but I do get people asking me, like, am I working with the government or the devil? You know, like, there's religious concerns sometimes, and there's people that are concerned about the technology somehow ruling over their lives, and I'm like, no, we're actually taking control of the technology. We're using it in our own lives.
I shall be one with the Matrix.
So is your intention to basically have us all chipped by a certain point in time? Is that your secret plan?
My secret plan is to make this technology available to people who would want to get one. So like, I'm not saying if you don't want one, you're getting one anyway. What I am saying is if you want one, you don't have to wait now for the Apples and Googles and Samsungs of the world. You know, you could get one done at a local piercing shop with a very accessible and cheap kit. Do you want one? We could do it.
I don't know about that. Amal Grafstra, it's been very weird chatting to a cyborg. Lovely, but weird. It's great to meet you, thanks.
All right, great meeting you.